Hi everybody, welcome back. My name is Lynn and I am Pretty Papercraft 67, and today I am following along with Rachel from Roxy's Creations for the Roxy's Weekly Challenge, week number 17. And this challenge is doing colour swatches. So I have did a little bit of work in advance and I just made a couple of tags just with some watercolour. And I've got some fabric, some calico, I've got some scrapbook paper, some book page, a word finder, some sketchbook and some canvas. So I thought we'll just do a little bit of playing and see what we come up with. I do love watercolour. I am no expert at it, that's for sure. So this is a minty scrapbook paper and I love the muted tones in the background, so we just might have a bit of a fiddle. I have got my paint palette over to the side here. So I did have a little bit of a fiddle with some pinks this afternoon. So I'm just gonna sort of try and tone down some of these colors just by adding bits of white and so on and so forth. And we'll see how we go. And how is everyone today? I hope everyone is well. Beautiful, beautiful weather here in Brisbane. If you're in Queensland, I'm not sure about the other states, how cold it's getting down there, but I am very much enjoying this cooler weather. Okay, so we'll see what comes of these colours. Okay, so this is kind of like a bit of a lilac-y colour. I'll just put some on here. I don't even know how this is going to work on this scrapbook paper. Isn't that pretty colour? Okay, so purple. And now we've got a bit of a darker purple here. A bit too much water in that. I have seen a few different channels doing this kind of thing over time. Leslie from 507 Willow House Journals, I think it is. She was doing color swatches some time ago. She includes those in her journals. They're really a nice idea. Now we'll go in with a bit of pink. It's quite therapeutic. And then we'll go a bit darker pink. Oh, it's pretty. Okay, let's see what we can do about blue. I've got some blue here. Take a bit of water off that brush. So I'm not sure about the scrapbooking paper. It is pretty, but I don't know if you're getting the true colour, if that makes sense. Let's go for a really dark blue. Well, that's pretty. That's like a tealy blue. I like that. That's pretty. Like an ocean blue. And that's kind of like a lilac-y colour, even though it's blue. Huh. Isn't it weird how the colour variations? Now, I'm just going to take a little bit of that. And see what that comes out like. Oh, that's nice too. And got a bit of green over here. We'll mix a bit of green with some blue and see what we get. Well, that's green, isn't it? Yeah, that's more green than blue. I think I like watercolour for or painting for this because it's always different and you're just adding a little bit of this and a little bit of that. Oh, that's really nice. All right, so that's on the scrapbooking paper. Got a bit of blue there. A blue background one, but I might just put that to the side. So that's on scrapbooking paper, and that's quite pretty. Now I'm going to do some on the book pages. This is the same book page as these two ones, these two bookmarks. I'm just going to rip a bit, and we'll just have a fiddle with this. Now what I did with this one, before I added the colour down, I did paint some squares with just white. So I'm not doing that this time, so we'll just see how the colours go. Now this time we might go a bit of green. And we'll see how we go. And I might just change my brush. I might just do it with this one. That's nice. Put a bit of white. I like it on the book page. Oh, I like that bit of white. I like it on the book page, and I think I like it on the book page because you can see the text through it. Oh, that's really nice. It's funny, hey, I'm using one colour green and just adding different pieces, different colours to it, and we're getting all these different greens. Let's see what this one does. Oh, that's sort of similar. And a little bit more yellow. Oh, that's really pretty. Alright, so that's the book page, and now I might just do a bit of oranges down the bottom of that. Bring this one in. It's like a terracotta colour. And I'll add a bit of white to that. And I'm going to add a little bit of brown to that. And then I think I'm going to bring in a little bit of, oh, what colour do I like? Might be a bit of red into that and see what that comes out like. Yeah, they would look really nice in a journal, wouldn't they? Like a journaling card, or instead of, you could have them like as a paper sampler. Oh, they're really nice. All right, so that's the book page and the scrapbook paper. Now let's try it on this stuff. This is just like a, it's porous like a watercolor paper, but it's thin like copy paper, but it's actually sketchbook. So, oh, now what colors can we try? Let's go a bit of golden. that. That takes the colour quite nicely, this paper. And it's like a mustardy yellow colour. A little bit more water. What will we add to that? A bit of white. Yeah, that's nice too. And then I might just put a little bit of orange in that yellow. Oh, that's gone very, very orange. Like my glue, I'm a bit of a messy painter. Oh, that's nice too. Look at that, beautiful. All right, and then we'll go for a bit of the browns. Got a very dark brown. I might add that into some of that orange. Oh, I like it. Now I'll make it a little bit darker. I don't know the proper names of the paints. And these are a liquid paint, they're not a cake. I've never used watercolour, like the pans, I think they're called. I've only ever used the liquid paint. So you probably will find a whole lot of difference in different styles and quality. Obviously, quality of paint is a big thing too. The browns aren't giving much variation, are they? I'm just mixing the brown with the orange and the yellow. I guess it's all on the sort of colour wheel. Oh, there are slight variations there. And yeah, I can see these would look really pretty. You could cut them into tags like I've done this one, these two. Or you can make them a page embellishment. You can turn them into a journal card. You could do a lot with them. Now we might try to do just some white and then grey and black. And that would pretty much... So you're probably not going to see the white on the white. I think it's still got a bit of brown in there, but that's okay. So white, and then we'll add just a touch of black. We'll need white. And we've got a bit of grey. And then we'll go straight black. Now, I'm not adding a lot of water to mine because I don't know, I just kind of like that thicker appearance that will still dry, it'll still dry lighter. All right, so that is the sketchbook. Now, I don't even know if it's going to work, but I've got a little bit of this canvas paper here that I can run through my printer. I don't know if it will work. It does have like a sheen to the top of it, like a coating. Oh, that's the back side. I think, that may be what I've been doing wrong. That's the canvas side. All right, let's have a play and see if we can get something on this canvas, because that could be a nice fabric flip. Pardon me. I'm going to change brushes again because that one's quite dirty. Alright, so I'm going to start over back over here with the pink. Oh, that takes that colour so nicely, that paper. That's our pink. Got a bit of light pink. I like this canvas paper. A bit of purple. Well, it's not canvas paper, it's actually canvas sheets that you can run through your printer. I found them at Office Works. And then we'll go a bit lighter purple. A bit of white. I'm not very straight. Oh, it's really pretty. All right, and then we'll go on to some blue. Yeah, so fun. It is fun. I do love to watercolour. I just can't draw very well, that's all. And we'll go a bit darker blue. Add a bit of white to the blue, make it a bit lighter. Yet. It's all a surprise. I like it, I like it. That's nice. We might as well just do all the colours again. So I've got a bit of green. And I'll add a bit of mustardy colour. I'm sure it's not called mustardy colour, but that's what colour I call it. And add a bit more green to that. Everything, every time you add just a little bit more, it just changes the shade just a little bit. Nice. It's a bit of red over here. A bit of that in there, see what we get with a bit of brown and red. Probably get that terracotta-y colour again. Oh, I like it, very nice. And then there's just one last one I'd like to try, and Rachel did it on some fabric. Now I've got some calico. So let's put it on some calico and see what happens again. I'm going to go back to my pink. I'm just very interested to see how this goes. Oh, it soaks in real quick. I need to use a lot more water when you're doing it on fabric. But that's quite pretty. Alright, now we'll do a bit of purple. I get a little bit quiet. I don't know. I just concentrate. Things like this do relax me, I will admit. So I just get sort of a bit zoned out. Oh, that's nice. Let's go for a bit of blue. That's nice too. I like the fabric, I really do. I think that's nice. I'm just playing with blue. We've got this really deep purple at the moment, so let's have a look what this looks like. Nice. It's a shame I can never get the same the same colour again. Oh, I do like the purple. I do like the calico. I think that's nice. Lovely. Now, I know that Rachel went on and did some slow stitching and so forth, but I'm really not a slow stitcher. I love the end result, but I'm just pretty happy to leave it here because I'm really, really wrapped with the results that we've achieved on these mediums. So we've got scrapbooking paper, and that's almost dry now, so I like that. You can see the pattern through that. Then we've got book page. I think that would be a favourite. I love that you can see the text come through. Then we've got this sketchbook paper. That's nice too. And then we've got the canvas. And then we have the calico. So yes, definitely worth a little play. And they're just, I have, like I've said, I've seen other crafters use them in journals and just, you know, stick that to a page. You could sew around it and decorate it. You could cut it and have little tags made out of it, you know, that make a nice foundation for a collage. Lots of things you could do with it. The calico, if you really took your time and made it all very pretty, that could be a lovely fabric flip. So yeah, interesting. And I just did them before, sewed around them, and now they're a nice little journal tag. Brilliant. All right, everyone, thank you so much for joining me tonight. I'll see you all in the next video. Thanks so much and stay safe and well. Bye for now.